Welcome to Our Saviour's Lutheran Church on this fourth Sunday of Advent. Wait, is it the fourth Sunday of Advent? Or is it Christmas Eve? It's both. Because Christmas Eve falls on a Sunday this year, it is both the fourth Sunday of Advent and Christmas Eve. So to begin this brief time of worship together, I will light all four Advent candles as we sing together, O come, Emmanuel. Welcome again to this brief time of devotion and song on this fourth Sunday of Advent, as we are now so close to Christmas Eve. Whenever I hear the refrain of, O come, Emmanuel, I'm reminded of a Bible passage from Philippians chapter 4. It's actually from Philippians chapter 4, verse 4, which is perfect on this fourth Sunday of Advent. Philippians 4, 4 says, "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be made known to everyone. The Lord is near." Those are almost the exact same words that we sing in O come, Emmanuel. The refrain of that song says, "Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel." You likely know what the word Emmanuel means. It means God is with us. Or as we heard in Philippians, the Lord is near. It's on Christmas, especially, that we celebrate how God is with us, how God is near to us. And we sing about it in so many of our Christmas carols. For example, we sing, "Joy to the world, the Lord is come." In other words, the Lord is with us. In the third verse of Away in a Manger, we sing, "Be near me, Lord Jesus. I ask you to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray." In O Little Town of Bethlehem, we sing, "O Holy Child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today." That's the good news of Christmas. That's the good news of every day as followers of Jesus, that God comes to live with us, that God comes to live among us, and that God comes to live within us. And we are now so close to celebrating that good news that God always is so close to us. When we get to the very end of Advent, it reminds me of the many times in my life when I've either run out of gas or nearly run out of gas. Are you one of those people, or do you know one of those people who loves to push it to the limit when driving? I don't do this very much anymore because I have learned my lesson. But when I first started driving, I always thought it was fun to see how far I could drive once the gas tank was on empty. Thinking back on it now, it certainly wasn't the smartest thing to do, but I did it anyway. Well, there was one time when a friend of mine and I were driving from California to Arizona. We were on a fun road trip when the gas tank started getting low. We passed a gas station that we probably should have stopped at, but we didn't. Instead, we just kept on driving through the Arizona desert. Another 20 miles or so down the road, the car started to sputter while we were in the middle of nowhere. It was then that, as a couple of college kids, we literally started to pray out loud. We prayed for a gas station to appear. We prayed that the car would keep on driving on fumes. And then, what to our wondering eyes did appear but a sign for a gas station coming up near? We were just 1 mile away from a gas station when the car sputtered again and then again. And just when we could see the gas station off in the distance, the car completely ran out of gas. We coasted as far as we could. And then my friend did something unexpected. He jumped out of the car while it was still moving. Kids, don't ever try this, please. It wasn't moving fast, but it was moving just fast enough that he was able to keep the momentum of the car moving forward. And somehow, we made it all the way to the gas station. My friend, his name is Jess, he was like an angel that day. He flew out of the car as if he had wings. He gave us just enough of a nudge to get us where we needed to go, and we rejoiced, truly. On this fourth Sunday of Advent, just hours before Christmas Eve, this church is empty, but soon it will be filled to the brim. Perhaps you are running on empty today. Perhaps you are running out of gas, literally or figuratively. However you are feeling today, exhausted or energized, weary or wide awake, may God's Holy Spirit give you a little nudge into Christmas. May a surprise angel appear to get you exactly where you need to be. In fact, we have a Christmas angel with us today. Our own director of music, Matt Haider, is going to give us a preview of what is to come. He's going to play for us the introduction to our Christmas Eve opening hymn, but he won't play for us the whole thing because that's what's coming in just a few hours. Oh, come all ye faithful. It's time to celebrate the fourth Sunday of Advent, and soon, so very soon, the good news of Christmas.